Hello and welcome to Let's Play Song of the Ocean, the Legend of Heroes series. Technically, it's The Legend of Heroes 5, but they call it 3 here. This is the fourth game I've been playing in the series. Long forgotten are the days before the land was cloven by Gagarv. I'll be playing this blind, and I read all the things, as you can tell, when the three worlds existed as one. So I really don't know anything about this other than it's the same as the previous two games, very similar in gameplay. It takes place in the same world. The crack in the earth is the scar of our sins, but each game takes place in a different land that's separated by the Gagarv, which you can see there. How long have you been living in guilt? Of course, it's the precursor to Trails in the Sky, which I hope to play eventually. Maybe not right after this, but I want to get to it. Hundreds of years ago, it is said the Water Tribe lived by the sea before disappearing without a trace. Legends say that they used melodies to convert sound into energy, building a civilization that thrived beyond our wildest dreams. Perfect, pure, all-powerful melodies, however, the tales told little more, so they were but one of many myths of the distant past. A little hard to keep up with. But then, a rumor began spreading among those in the musical trade that one great musician had revived the ancient melodies. The musician's name was Leon Friedrich Richter. He was known across the world as a celebrated performer and a young musical prodigy. However, even 50 years later, the truth of the rumor was never determined, and for most, it was but a distant memory. In those days, there were many troubadours. So I guess we're playing like bard-type characters in this game? Most of them were cheerful and erudite, seeking a greater duty beyond simple musical comforts. Their travels often took them throughout the world. This is the story of a troop of such troubadours. So again, guys, no spoilers, please. I don't think I even said it. Please, no spoilers. Playing blind. First time playing. I'm psyched. Also released on the PlayStation Portable, like the last two games. The Legend of Heroes, Chapter 3. Song of the Ocean. Originally called Cage Song of the Ocean. You press start, otherwise that plays over again. New game. This game, from what I understand, is the longest of all of them. Gagarv 943. I estimate about 120 episodes, I'm gonna say. Overture, Traveler's Prelude. Tear of Vermilion was 103 episodes, and Prophecy of the Moonlight Witch was 70-something? 80-something? I forgot. As you go on, they get longer and longer. I wonder what kind of fruit that is. Amateur, McBain says. Look at the status above his head. Forte, says nothing. You're driving the fish away. So it's my fault that you're not catching anything? Amateur. I practice because I know I need to. I'll be changing the text speed as soon as I get a chance to. Besides, you haven't caught anything today, have you? Amateur. Amateur yourself, McBain says. You're the amateur, Forte says. These guys have the best comebacks ever. Poorest of the poor, McBain yells. Poorest of the poor yourself. Amateur. Una says, are you two quarreling again? Forte says, hey, Una. Grandpa blames me for his lack of catches. Are you suggesting my fishing skills are lacking? Una says, I guess good friends fight more often. You know, Jan also thinks you're wasting your time with this quarrel of yours. Oh, okay, Jan's a dog who yawns. You bored him, huh? Una says, we're getting started with the processing, so if you're going to fight, do it somewhere else, okay? What are they processing? Fish? Fruit? Forte says, yeah, sure. Kale, well that is, says, yells, Grandpa Mac! Alright, we're getting a lot of characters introduced here. Here's a package for you. And a letter to go with it. They're from someone called Shio? McBain says, from Shio, is it? It's been a long time since I heard from him. Thank you, my boy. McBain receives a package and a letter. Kale says, I gotta get back on watch then. Thanks again. McBain says, ah, Shio, it's been a long time. Who's Shio? A friend of yours from your traveling days? Yep, he was our accordion player. McBain opens the letter. Maestro Dearest is writing, long time no see, Maestro. Be merry and dance. There's a very high, loud note there. He's weird, says Forte. Hey, no peeking. McBain puts the letter in his inner pocket. Hey, I was reading that, Forte says. So what's in the package, then? Good question. McBain says, I've wasted enough time trying to fish. The fish aren't going to bite with the cacophony yonder. Farewell, young amateur. The dog goes with him. Well, it's back to practice for me then. Okay, I guess he's reading the letter some more. Long time no see, Maestro. Be merry and dance. I'm writing to you about the book you always used to talk about. Look at the book, as they say. Believe it or not, someone I met on my travels had it. And what's more, he gave it to me. I never thought it really existed. Surprise, surprise. Anyway, I'm sending it to you on the double. It's been 10 years already since you retired. This book might give you the traveler's itch. We're planning to go on a tour of Grayskull soon. This makes me think of Grayskull. By the power of Grayskull. We might just see each other if we're lucky. Cheers, Shio. Ah, Shio. He writes just like how he talks. Yeah, with letters that appear on the screen. McBain opens the package and takes out a book. It reads Water Melody on the cover. Impressive. There are only a few of these books currently in existence. This is a rare find indeed. McBain opens Water Melody. Water Melody. It is said that the lost ancient people of the Water Tribe used a variety of powers by playing musical melodies. According to records on the tribe, they used 24 basic phrases associated with different powers. Each phrase had a theme. They were target, technique, perseverance, force, march, hermit, mirror, life, love, purification, fire, light, earth, water. Did they okay, it's life. Before. I thought they repeated one. Wind, darkness, spirit, lullaby, bind, mind's eye, quagmire, time, confusion, and birth. These phrases exert a great effect individually. However, the lost melody, which was created by mixing all those elements, was said to be powerful enough to save the world from destruction. This legend interested me very much. Music is, by its nature, very mysterious. Any emotions, such as joy, anger, and sadness, can be conveyed to the audience. If the ancient tribe knew the effects of the melodies and were manipulating them at will, this is not just a fable. This made me want to hear the lost melody. I completed a piece using all 24 phrases based on the few clues remaining today. I named this reconstructed piece the Water Melody. However, I was concerned that it might be used for wrong purposes. That is why I engraved each phrase on individual stones and named the 24 stones Resonance Stones. I decided to either entrust them to people I trust or hide them in dark caves and obscure places all over the world. I created a single magic map which the Resonance Stones would react to. I hope it never falls into the wrong hands. Leon Friedrich Richter. McBain says, it's a magic map. Grandma Shella says, are you ready to boil the seashells? Una says, yes, I'm ready. Grandma, you know what? Yes, what is it? I'm kind of fond of Forte. Oh yes, I know that. I mean, it's a little bit different from the way I like him because we grew up together. So you want to shift him from boyfriend to boyfriend, right? Do you think I should tell him I love him? Do you love him? Well, you said you're fond of him. That's two different things. That's a good question. If you can't get him out of your head, then maybe you should. But I'm really not good at this. I tried to tell him several times already, but I always hesitate at the last moment. Next thing I know, I'm telling myself I can always try again next time. Besides, I wouldn't be able to tell him I love him with other people around. My, my, I never realized you were so shy. Don't tell anyone, okay? Of course, of course. Bot? Bate? I'm gonna call him Bot. Alright, everyone, time to work. Cal says, let's make some dye and earn our pay. I forgot to do the old lady voice. McBain chuckles contentedly. I guess he's murmuring, it's as if the whole world is calling my name. For the first time in many years, things are starting to heat up. Forte is thinking, I guess. Grandpa's grinning to himself. I wonder what he's up to. Anyway, I've sent off my application for the recital in Pinzel. But which instrument should I play, the trumpet or the cithara? I'm not really confident with either. Well, I guess he was mumbling. McBain heard him. Not really confident, huh? Just shut your mouth and fall asleep. Forte says, whoops, sorry. Several days later. I still haven't got to a point where I can access the menu. Sleepy Tad, Forte. Was that the song he's playing? Guess so. Sleepy, like a tadpole? Or just a tad sleepy? Difference there. Whatever you do, don't call me an amateur, Forte says. McBain says, I heard you've applied for the Pinzel recital. Yep. What instrument will you be playing? The trumpet or the kithara? I'm not sure yet. Go with the kithara. What's a kithara? I mean, an instrument, obviously, but... Hey, not so fast, Forte says. McBain says, that's my hunch as a veteran musician. Some musicians are better suited to a certain instrument by birth. You will be a better player if you play the kithara instead of the trumpet. Anyway, it's time for me to go practice at the lighthouse. See ya, amateur. He loves teasing him like that, doesn't he? Practice? Says Forte. Hello, Grandma. I wonder if he's going to apply for the recital, too. I'm not used to seeing, like, someone coming over, like, as we're going through dialogue. I don't know, it was weird. How is your trumpet coming along, Forte? Okay, I guess. I don't do a lot of voices, but I like to do old people for some reason. The kithara is better suited for me, huh? At least when it comes to music, he has sound judgment. Oh! Okay. System. Message fast. Oh, there's less things this time. Combat pop-ups. I guess I'll leave them on. I'm not completely sure what that is. Save, load, delete. History. So in... Oh, AG, I guess, after Gagarth, 890. Leon completes the water melody, a recreation of the lost melody. The tune is divided into 24 phrases, and each segment is engraved on a stone so as to prevent its misuse. These stones are named the Resonance Stones. AG 943, McBain receives a package from Shao containing the book Water Melody by Leon, which McBain had been long searching for. We're not going to know any of this stuff because that just happened and this is after, well, would be afterwards. I don't think I checked the history either on A Tear of a Million when I was done. Alright, well, we got 1% history. Woo! Alright, so let's check out Forte with 47 hit points, 33 magic points. He's holding a bamboo sword, and he has on artist clothes. Okay, under items, we have music books. The score book. Forte's scorebook can collect many scores to increase your repertoire. So there's not a book I can read. I'm Fine, Old Kithara Song in Leto Ratudo Area. Fast rhythm cheers you up. Okay. And as for magic, it just says finishing moves and skills. Finishing move he has is Jump Rush, a sword technique to lash the enemy while jumping. And under skills, we have Attention, draws the enemy's attention and become the target. Ah, we have Taunt. It's Taunt. In EverQuest, it would be called Taunt. Just click the Taunt button as soon as it, comes from being grayed out, you know. So, I want to look at these items. I'm going to put them back on, don't worry. Bamboo sword. Small sword with a blade made of bamboo. Easy to use, but has little power. And what counts for armor? Artist clothes. Easy to move in and quickly dries. No protection, so don't count on it. That's why I read these things. I go out of my way to read this stuff. Okay. Now we look around. Alright, let's talk to whoever this is. Is this Una? Or Wusil? Hey, Forte. Listen, I've seen Mr. McBain going to the lighthouse a lot recently. I wonder if he's starting to practice music seriously again. Is he going to enter the Pinzo recital? What? My grandpa? I don't know, but he hasn't said anything, though. Roussel says, I heard Mr. McBain play the hand harp about 10 years ago. It was wonderful. 10 years ago? You were probably like 4. If he's going to perform at the recital, I'll be there for him for sure. Of course, I'll cheer for you too, Forte. Gee, thanks. Regul says, I wish I had more of a variety of dye colors to get from the shellfish. I could mix red ink with finely minced dried shellfish, or mixing with resin from the trees could create beautiful colors. Forte says, how about petals of flowers? Petals? Oh yeah, that's it. That way I can make more colors. Way to go, Forte. I'm going to talk with Grandma Shella after testing in various ways. If the colors increase, we'll get more orders from Kranka. I guess that's a city or a town. Kranka. As long as you don't get all cranky in Kranka. I'm trying to talk to everybody before, like, things move ahead. Oh, Forte. Oh, it's Grandpa Rito. Oh, Forte, there's something I always wanted to ask you. You know, Forte is learning how to play the kithara and the trumpet from McBain. Are you thinking about succeeding your grandpa and becoming a troubadour? I don't know yet. He talks about Forte like he's not standing right there. I like to perform, but I haven't decided anything yet. I'm sure your grandpa will be very happy if you succeed him. I'm really sure. Grandma Aura says, Forte, I heard that you're going to enter the recital in Pinzo. But is that true? Yes, I'm thinking about taking a part in it. Really? That sounds fun. Your grandpa is a splendid performer. I bet you must have talent as a musician as too. I was going to say as well for some reason. Alright. Don Hyo. Okay, we have some kind of shop here. I can't go behind the counter and annoy him. I always love doing that in the other games. Wow. He doesn't even say anything. Usually they have a little line come up saying, welcome to my shop. I have everything you might need, and they don't. But, oh wow. Cure bottle S. Well, we have no money at all. Look at that. Oh no, we have 10 gold. Wait a second. Oh no, that's 10 gold. We have zero everything. Wow. Even the first two games, we started with a little bit of money. Cure bottle S. Drink that slightly restores HP contained in a small bottle. And this considerably restores HP contained in a medium-sized bottle. Cure bottle M. Leash bottle S. Okay, that slightly restores magic points, and that considerably restores magic points. S, M. I guess medium. Purify potion. Drink that neutralizes poison. A little bitter, but you have to drink it. Lackety paste. Ointment that cures paralysis. Stimulates blood circulation. Restore snuff. Is that like beetle snuff? See ya, Deep Space Nine. Stimulating snuff. A strong smell that awakens unconscious people. I'm trying to think of the Grand Negus, how you do his voice. I want some beetle snuff! I can't really do it. Marbles. Beautiful glass marbles. Only throw them at monsters. I don't think I've ever used them. I was picking up, like, random stuff and just figured I have it and never ever used them, and they just sit in inventory forever. Not enough money. You have no items. Exchange reels to gents? 5 gents for each reel. Okay. Well, we can't buy anything. We'll have to come back here. We'll have to ask Grandpa for some money. Alright, so that's this whole area. Anything down here? I still have some other ways to go. Okay, we're getting far away from town now. Oh, it's a well. The breeze coming from the well is always cool, even in the summer. But when I imagine falling down, even my spine gets chilled. Well, stop imagining that, then. How dare you imagine things very bad. Okay, it ends here. Oh, continues. Oh, there's stairs now. I'm divided on whether to go back and check the other areas, or... Let me go back. I don't want to get stuck in a... like a cutscene or something. I have a feeling that we might ultimately supposed to be going there. After all this. Oh no, here's a cutscene! Ah! What the hell? Monkeys? Oh no! Monsters! No, they're monkeys. Jan, help me out! Woof! Jan joins the party. Is it like a Saint Bernard? Like, I don't know about a white Saint Bernard. I guess it's going to be albino. But I know they carry those. They typically have some kind of alcohol in there to warm people up in the cold winter months, and they rescue people. Alright, I'm getting into battle. I didn't expect that to happen so soon. So I haven't had a chance to check out the dog. 41 hit points, 28 magic points. He might have an item on him in that barrel. Yeah, I was right, they are monkeys. Perro cure. Well, that's interesting, because perro means dog in Spanish. Heals a small amount of damage for a single character. Well, we don't need that. Not yet, anyway. Does the dog have skills? Hunt item. Hunting for enemy items. Well, let's defeat some first, and we'll hunt for items. No items. Jan going first. Says woof. Forte says here. Alright, one monkey down. Monkey! Monkey, monkey! Let's attack monkey C! Ouch! Alright. Let's hunt for an item. Don't kill it first. Purify potion stolen. That's a good dog. That's a good boy. That's a good boy. Very good boy. Win. Oh, look at this. Oh, it shows up with the battle results on, like, sheet music. I love it. We found 12 whatever that can be changed into gents. Okay. Let me just go back before we get in more battles. I have a feeling there's more people to talk to that maybe we should have spoken to first. I'm not sure. If I see anyone with an exclamation mark over their head, then I'm probably gonna skip them and keep running back and forth. Okay, this is where the store is, right? Right, we have a little bit of money. So we can see how the exchange goes. I'm not gonna buy anything yet. 5 gents for each rill. So that means we'll have 60 gents. Nice. Math. I can do math. Oh my god. I feel so empowered. Just don't ask me to do long division. Okay, grandparents. Well, there's 2 people here. Una's father. I guess we don't need to know his name. Hi, Forte. Hello. I hear Grandpa McBain practicing the hand harp lately. I bet he's going to go on a trip. You'd better be careful. You think so too, huh? Says Forte. The Pinzol recital is coming too. The father says, we wouldn't enroll for the recital, but still, his blood as an itinerant artist is getting stirred up. Una's mother. Hi, Forte. What good weather we have today. Fortis, because Una's mom calls me Forte. What else should she call you? Una calls me that, too. Then what's your actual name? Everyone's been calling you Forte. Good luck on the Pinzol recital. Oh, and just don't say thank you or anything. How rude. Wow. Plant. Four beds. I guess Una has a sibling. Probably someone we already met too, and I just didn't notice or forgot. Okay, I've talked to her. So let's go back. Alright, back here. Can I walk along? No. Okay, so we have this way, and then we have this house here. Oh, that's it. Excuse me. Trying to explore. Thank you very much. Oh, it goes up here. Alright, let's talk to them. Stop moving. Hi, Forte. Are you done with practicing your trumpet? If you have time, you could look around our job here. We collect red ink from shellfish around here. We process it to get dye stuff like this, and that's how we make our living in Racos Palma. I guess that's the town we're currently in. Even though we don't have any fertile land, we can manage to live on the blessings of the sea. Bot says, Forte, take good care of Grandma McBain. Grandpa McBain, he may seem goofy, but you're the only reason for living since his wife passed away 5 years ago. Forte says, goofy? That's kind of mean. I respect my grandpa as a troubadour, although I may not show it all the time. It's okay, says Bot. At any rate, this village doesn't develop at all. So he's saying it's mean, and he just says, it's okay. Like, just say you don't care. Racos Palma is along the seashore, but because of the rocky stretch, the fishing boats can't be tied up. Even big ships get stranded just like your wrecked ship house. I wish the sea was calm enough to be able to build a port. Then this village could have been a little more lively with taverns. You're too young to be going to taverns. We'll get back here. At any rate, this village doesn't develop at all. Racos Palma is along the seashore, but because of the rocky stretch, the fishing boats can't be tied up. Even big ships get stranded just like your wrecked ship house. Oh, did I read all that? I'm sorry, guys. Hi, Forte, Una says. We're almost ready to deliver the dye stuff to Krenka. Let's go deliver it later together. Everybody looks busy, so please give them a hand. Okay, Roger, Forte says. Roger, Dodger. Kel says, well, I think we can get ready for all the dye stuff we have to deliver to Krenka. Whose turn is it to deliver today? Is it my turn? If so, it's a pain. I wonder if someone can do it for me. I like to work here, but it's just a delivery job I hate. I should suggest to Grandma Shella to hire someone to make a delivery. Oops. Oh, what the hell? I keep pressing that button one too many times. Alright, we're still looking around. Can I... Oh, I can't get there from here. And get me out of here. Oh. Yep, these are the people I just talked to. Alright. Is there anything further this way? No. There is the other way, though. I know. What is over here? Forte's mother. Forte, have you seen Grandpa? See, she calls you Forte also. He should be at the lighthouse. At the lighthouse? Don't tell me he's practicing up there again. I think so. Why? Oh no, that's just what I thought. I gotta go tell your father. Honey! Okay. The dog? Yeah, no items. Oh, we can give him, like, these kind of, like, neck or, like, goes around your neck. There were other things that, like, had this icon in the other games that weren't necklace. They were, like, you know, gauntlets and stuff like that. I just had to hear that sound. That much hasn't changed. Alright, there's some kind of argument going on in there. I'm going to call in an episode here, and then we'll go see what's going on with these two. And we'll look around the area some more, hopefully. Thanks so much for watching, and see you next time, and always, seek adventure.